I just have to say, I've been going a little off script. I'm wearing Leslie's lipstick right now. I left my lipstick at home, and she lent me hers. And if you know Lesli, that's pretty signature. That's like a big deal. So it feels very apt, and I feel very happy to be coated in your lipstick love. Lesli Linka Glatter is one cool cat. In fact, one of her many nicknames, and there is a direct correlation between number of nicknames and affection. One of her many nicknames is LL Cool G. It's true. She is cool not only because she wears both motorcycle boots and pearls, but because she lives her life and makes her work with fierceness and abandon. Her choices are specific, and her trajectory is singular. Let's consider her origin story. How many directors do you know who start out as modern dancers in New York and Paris and evolve to choreographer in Tokyo? Not many, right? Like, not a whole lot. How many directors who, after a chance meeting with a sagacious Japanese man, decide that she needs to tell his story, and the only way to do that is through cinema? And then that film, her first ever, spoken in Japanese, in period, full of flashbacks, gets nominated for an Academy Award. How many directors debut, gets the attention of Steven Spielberg, her first mentor and producer of her second film? How many directors' first foray into episodic television is the mind and medium-bending treasure Twin Peaks? There are no Lesli Linka Gladders. There's just the one. And what's so cool about Lesli is that she, in her uniqueness, wants nothing more than to work in collaboration with others. Not only does she eagerly engage with her peers, she recruits and champions those who are not yet fairly represented in our industry. She is a staunch advocate for the advancement of women below and above the line. It's a cause that she takes as seriously as her own career. There's never a day on set in which she's not shadowed by a burgeoning female director. She glows. She glows when she talks about the triumphs of her countless mentees. And it's no coincidence that Homeland consistently earns the highest grades in the Hollywood Diversity Report. It's true. It's like a big deal. Lesli is cool, but she is far from indifferent. No. No, Lesli is about as present and enthusiastic as they come. A former Texas cheerleader, that's right. Modern dancer and cheerleader. She's always, even on a muddy location at 4 a.m, blasting the most infectious of smiles. She greets every crew member by name, and she constantly encourages a tight sense of community and connectivity. This beautiful, boundless energy, this unwavering commitment, informs her identity as a director. One of my favorite pastimes is watching Lesli watch the actors perform on the monitor in Video Village. Leaning forward, legs wide, hands on knees, Her face is about 2 inches away from the screen. Her head bobs in unison with the actor. She grins when charmed. She cries when moved, and will, more than occasionally, actually mouth the dialogue word for word. There's no question that when Lesli is directing, the actor's performance is being watched. It's being inhaled with rapturous appreciation. It's no wonder that under her eye and guidance, we're able to do our strongest, bravest work. Her company, her psychic fusion, emboldens us to venture into deep, uncharted, scary places. Lesli, as a girl, thought that if she broke the TV screen, and this is a direct quote, that all the characters would come out and play with me as well as my going in to play with them. She said, I went as far as getting my baseball bat before I got busted. And not much has changed. She's still there, bat in hand, ready to play. To play hard and loud and smash screens and glass ceilings. To tell big and small stories about Navy SEALs and teenage girls. To explore the realms of emergency rooms, terrorist cells, cop precincts, and White House halls with love and cheer and focus and nerve. Lesli has a phrase when we're towards the end of shooting a scene and we feel confident enough that we've got all the material we need. She'll often suggest that we do one more take for the ancestors. So I suggest now that as we watch this reel of Lesli's incredible work, we do so with the ancestors in mind. Let's recall this award's namesake, the first female member of the DGA, Dorothy Arzner, and all those who have followed her. And let's honor, too, all the future women who will join in this amazing continuum. All the women who Lesli has helped nourish and inspire. So, for the ancestors and the successors, here's a look at Lesli's brilliant contributions to film and television.
Choose for ourselves together.
Does that help to clear things up for you?
Time is here, don't go to sleep. Straight to
I heard Kim punched you in the chest really hard. Oh, whoops, that was me.
Oh!
I want you to kill my father.
He systematically pulled you apart, Brody. Piece by piece.
When nothing's right, just close your eyes, and you're gone.
Looking your eye, and I got that red lip, classic thing that you
Oh my goodness. Thank God I didn't bring my baseball bat. Oh, thank you. This is extraordinary, and I am so honored to be receiving this award from Women in Film, an organization that is all about women empowering other women, and an award named after the extraordinary Dorothy Arzner, who is the first woman to join the Directors Guild to direct a sound film, and she was credited with creating the boom microphone. And she was also known for fostering other women's careers. I am both completely humbled and thrilled to be joining the list of past recipients. And of course, as I look around this room, I am both completely thrilled about the talent and experience sitting here, many of my colleagues. I've been extremely fortunate to have been working on Homeland for the last four seasons, a show about a very complicated, brilliant, complex, bipolar, not always likable, sorry, but always compelling and complex female character in a totally morally ambiguous world that exists largely in shades of gray and not in black and whites. How did this ever get made? It got made because of these incredible people I happen to be sitting with. I work with Alex Ganza, who has created the most wonderful and creative working environment where everyone is encouraged to bring their A game and do their best possible work and the best idea wins. And I get to do this with the extraordinary Claire Danes, who has made me a much more fearless director. And I am forever indebted, you know. And I love you dearly, you know. It has been an extraordinary journey, and even on the hardest days, I am grateful to be able to do the job I do, to be a storyteller. Truffaut said, "The secret of good directing is knowing exactly what you want, but having no ego about giving it up the second anyone has a better idea." So in this amazing team sport that we are in, I was recently asked about my directing bullet points and what they are. And it literally took me down a memory lane of mentors' advice and personal experience. So here they are. Be tenacious, very tenacious, and don't let anyone tell you you can't do it. Trust your instincts. Don't pretend to know something you don't. You will get caught. Don't be afraid to be simple. Learn everyone's name on the set on the very first day. Have a huge BS detector. Wear comfortable shoes, which I'm not right now. Don't worry about things you can't control. Worry about the things you can. Be tender. Give back every day. Remember, you are very lucky to be doing what you are doing. And lastly, reapply lipstick. You don't have to give up being a woman to do the job. All of my Homeland friends are laughing because they're used to seeing the whole monitor cart filled with like beverages that have lipstick marks all over them. I was helped, mentored, and encouraged by amazing and talented men and women. But if you would have told me 25 years ago when I started directing, 25 years ago, that we would still be talking about the abysmal hiring of women directors in 2016 and unconscious bias, I would have said impossible. There's no way this will still be an issue, but sadly, as we all know, it still is, and it's time. It's time for true change, and right now we're at a tipping point, and this is it. It's not easy for anyone to be a director. It's not for the faint of heart, but it shouldn't be harder for our daughters than it is for our sons. It should be an equal playing field. Yeah. Yeah. And to affect real change, we have to support women in front of and behind the camera and defy conventional thought in terms of what women can and can't do. Women can direct action and comedy and dinosaurs and drama and superheroes. It's about talent and artistic passion, not gender. Yeah. So for all of you, all of us, who are here in a position to hire, to mentor the next generation, or help a mid-career director get back in the game, until it's truly an equal playing field, we need to do just that. Take one hand and open the door. And if it doesn't work the first time, do it again and again till we have created true change. I want to thank all of those men and women who opened the door for me and helped me along the way. Thank you so much for this honor. Thank you.